Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching for Tech. Few days before, we introduced the new custom ROM called as linageos Android 15. It's a pure AOSP with combinations of pixelOS and Lineage's stability, performance and features. You'll find its in-depth preview given in our card video. Recently, linageos trying to release their new Android 16 based build, but before release of final custom ROM, they made available their Android 16 based custom JSA version. Today in this video, we are going to review this build. We'll check out its new source base, its working essential things, its new Android 16 features, its major plus point, that is the performance, and at the end, we'll discuss all of its perks and missing Android 16 features. So watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. I booted this JSA build on my OnePlus 9RT. You can also try this on any device. For detailed instruction to flash this, please check video given in iCard. If you check its device details, this is the AOSP Treble linageos Android 16 build. As this is a Treble Droid JSA build, it's showing device name as TDGSI ARM64AB. It has security patches of June 2025. Build date of ROM is of 16 June 2025. As this ROM is based on the Android 16 beta build, its build number in the QS panel will be mentioned as 16BP2A250605.31A. So you got another Android 16 based custom JSA ROM. Soon linageos will release their custom ROM version once all bugs will be fixed. As JSA build have different issues, I tested its all features like Wi-Fi, hotspot, NFC, GPS, screencast. I didn't found any issues for such essential features. Even when I did the sensor testing for accelerometer, light, proximity, magnetometer, compass, gyroscope, all are working fine on my device. Other essential features like ear speaker, mic, display, multi-touch, etc. also working. Calling with the LTE data network are working for me. So first impression of ROM is looking very good, but still it has some major bugs and missing features that I have discussed in the bug section of this video. So don't miss that part. Now let's check out all the Android 16 features available for this build. Though this ROM is based on the Android 16 beta source code, it has some expressive 3 design changes like this new QS panel with new brightness slider, new QS panel tiles with new on and off toggle animations. Editing pages of QS panel tile have same Android 16 look with bouncy animation while adding or moving tiles. Notification panel have same Android 16 user interface. All the notifications have rounded icons and there are two different buttons like manage and clear all are available at the bottom of notification panel. New background blur effect is working while accessing QS panel. This gives the glass blur like effect while accessing QS panel anywhere in the system. Settings panel and new big rounded setting icons with multiple colors. All options have new card like UI. On and off toggles of settings have new X and checkmark like user interface of Android 16. New Android 16 adopted the new battery icon in the status bar, which resembles with the iOS battery icon style. Except these new material expressive design changes, we got new Android 16 features like this live notifications. These notifications will show the current activity of notifications like this Android 16 spaceship Easter egg game. In a live notification, it's showing its current position and location of spaceship. This feature is especially useful for Zomato, Swiggy, Blinkit like food and grocery delivery applications to show their live status of orders. In the system and gesture setting for double press power button, we got new wallet option. This will help you to open Google Wallet application by simply double pressing power button. But it's not working because Google Wallet application is not supported in India. Android 16 recent stocks menu got new select and close shortcuts which are available in this build also, but recent selection is buggy for this ROM. New home screen long press menu have this new app list feature which helps you to quickly open all app drawer applications. So these are all Android 16 features and new user interface changes this ROM offers. As already told in the intro, this is a combination of Pixel Experience and LineageOS features. All PixelOS features are available and working, like all Pixel device widgets are available with their opening and closing animations. Google Circle to search and Gemini assistants are available and working. ROM have the Pixel launcher as a default launcher. The signature feature of this ROM is its fluidity. Even though it's an initial build, everything is buttery smooth. Apps opening and closing, switching between applications, scrolling, smoothness, touch response, gaming, everything is best. No hitting issues or lags are there in this ROM. I think this is the best performing first Android 16 based GSI build till the date. But as GSI builds are not developed for the specific device, they may have different bugs on different devices. Like in my OnePlus 9RT, OnePlus alert slider is not working at all. It will also not work for any of OnePlus devices for the GSI build. ROM didn't have working fingerprint or face unlock, so you have to use password or pattern lock for security. Google Pixel unlimited photo backup is also not working for this build, but we will get it working in upcoming builds. LTE data networks are working, but for calling, only 2G calling is supported. Unfortunately, Bluetooth is also not working, it's not turning on at all. Basic device and strong integrity checks are failing, even the Google Play Protect is uncertified in this build. But in my device, all the banking and payment applications, along with messaging applications, are working well. I don't know if all devices will able to make all security applications even after failing of Play integrity checks. Though this ROM has expressive material U3 design look, but some parts of user interface didn't have this, like volume panel is still of old style. New Android 16 expressive design 3 have new slider control for settings, which looks resembles with user interface of brightness slider of QS panel. But it's not available in this build. In the lock screen notification, no compact and expanded view setting control is available for lock screen notifications, which is present in a stable Android 16 release. So these are all the issues I found. As this is the initial build, who can accept these issues, but different devices may respond in a different way to this build. They may or may not face such issues as I mentioned here, or they may get other issues except this. So you have to try it yourself on your device and let us know in the comment section. Is it working for you or not? This is all about for today guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.